Syria war. Dozens of civilians killed in Inster Ghouta strikes.
Bombardments by Syria government forces have killed dozens of civilians in the rebel-held Eastern Ghouta are outside Damascus, activists say.
In Florida, aftermath U.S. students say never again. The students of Major Stoneman Douglas High School were well practiced in how to respond in actively shorter situation. The school has lockdown drills, security systems, and restricted entrances. But the Saul Goodman on Valentine's Day was still able to kill 17 people.
The cell phone computer social networks can real become a real addiction. Rehab clinics are being opened to cure this evil.
Celebrities come together and the Time's Up movement. In the month of January during Golden Globes event, what does the movement mean? You will see all this and more now in the last news.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
In Syria, at least 77 civilians, including 20 children, were killed in air strikes and rocket attacks on Monday, and Syria Observatory for Human Rights said.
It's believed that army is preparing and a growth offensive is hurting the suspicion of the bombing, a UN official said the situation of our control.
In Florida, from the schools, survivors and other students across the U.S. movements have sprung up. In its aftermath, reject what has been dubbed the new normal for their generation. Thousands of teenagers, including men still too young to vote, have become groups, a tool for their ideas and campaigns to speed.
Their call for gun control are not different to those in the aftermath of other tragedies, but the mentality and veracity of the students publicly voicing their demands has led many on social media to say this. Time feels different.
Time's up. During the Golden Event Watch took place on January 7 in London, several celebrities took part in the demonstrations of the movement, a legal advocacy fronted protesting to support women dealing with health abuse and adoption in the entertainment industry.
For the ceremony, several actresses dressed in black to denounce the sexual harassment suffered by women in Hollywood. For many, the actress' signature attire was what a grunt as it was said, but the event was a grandiose opportunity to talk about it and of the premier ceremonies in American television. Time's up. Use your voice.
Now we'll have the weather forecast, Gabriele.
Good afternoon, everyone. Well, we share the day in the Vinny seat of the state, Minnesota, and rising story. Big snowfall, the diamond in the region is the average temperature of 13.2 Fahrenheit. Prepare your coats. Missouri, the climate is moving agradable, rushing 70 Fahrenheit, with a possible weather fails during the day. For day is this, no wind is white, you, Juliana and Amabile, have a good afternoon.
Thank you, Gabriele. Have you calculated how many hours you spend in front of computer using yourself and social networks? Can they become an addiction? We went the street to know what people think about it.
How many hours do you spend using on your cell phone?
I don't know, about 5 hours maybe. I work with it, so...
Did you know that spend a lot of time on your cell phone is considered an addiction according to studies?
Really? I never stopped to think about it. Really, today's generation spends a lot of time in social networks, or even through work. This is related to studying.
According to information, the clinics are being opened to people who stay more than 6 or 7 hours in front of those mechanisms. The treatments last about 6 months for each patient.
For today, this is it. Stay with a local programming show. War City, see you soon and have a good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.